Hey, Sid, will you relax? I know you a long time. I'm not worried. I know you'll pay me back. Don't tell me what I already know. Don't embarrass me. So you had a few bad months. You do what everybody else does. I don't care if it's J.P. Morgan or Irving the Taylor. You write it out.
Vic Vega's outside.
Hold on. Oh.
Vic Vega.
Oh, tell him to come in. I gotta go.
Come on in.
Friend of mine's outside. Keep your chin up. I'll be talking to you. Don't worry. Hey, welcome home, Vic. How does freedom feel, huh?
It's a change.
Ain't that the sad truth? Sit down, take your coat off, make yourself at home. Want a little drink?
Yeah.
How about a little Remy Martin?
Sure.
Who's your parole officer?
Seymour Scagnetti.
How is he?
He's a fucking asshole. Won't even let me leave the halfway house.
You know, it never ceases to amaze me. Fucking jungle bunny goes out there, slits some old woman's throat for 25 cents. He gets Doris Day for a parole officer. Good fella like you winds up with a ball-busting prick.
I want you to know I appreciate all the packages you sent me on the inside.
Hey, what the hell was I supposed to do? Forget about you?
I just want you to know that it meant a lot to me.
Hey, it was the least I could do. I wish the hell I could have done a lot more.
Thanks a lot, Joe.
Vic. Toothpick, Vic. Now tell me a story, kid. What are your plans?
You son of a bitch. I see you sitting there, but I don't believe it. How you doing, Toothpick?
Hey, Eddie.
Listen, I'm sorry. I should have picked you up myself. This week's been crazy. I've had my head on my ass the whole time.
That's funny you should say that, because that was what me and your daddy were just talking about.
And I should have picked you up.
Now that you had your head up your ass. I walk in the door, he's like, Vic, Vic, I'm so glad somebody's finally here who knows what's going on. My son Eddie's a fuck-up. He's ruining the business. I mean, I love the guy, but, you know, he's flushing everything down the toilet. I mean, that's what you said, right, Joe? I mean, tell him yourself.
Well, Eddie, I hate for you to hear it like this, but, you know, Vic come in and ask me how business was. You don't lie to a guy, just don't show you in his family.
It's very true.
All right, enough of this shit. Break it up. Yeah, this ain't a place to have.
Daddy, did you see that?
What?
The guy got me on the ground. He tried to fuck me.
You wish.
You sick bastard, Vic. You tried to fuck me in my father's office. Look, Vic, whatever you want to do in the privacy of your own home, go to it. But don't try to fuck me. I mean, I don't think you that way. I like you a lot, buddy, but I don't think you that way.
Listen, if I was a butt cowboy, I wouldn't even throw you to the posse.
No, you wouldn't. You keep him for yourself. You know, 4 years fucking punks up the ass. You appreciate a piece of prime rib when you see it.
It might break you in, nice guy, but it'd make you my dog's bitch.
Ain't that a sad sight, Daddy? Man walks into prison, a white man walks out talking like a fucking nigger. You know what? I think it's all that black semen been pumped up your ass so far. Now it's backed into your fucking brain. It's coming out your mouth.
Eddie. You keep talking like a bitch, I'm gonna slap you like a bitch.
Come on, man!
All right, enough of that shit! I'm sick of it. I both of you, sit down.